Hello students, in this video I am going to explain you all about the determination of porosity of a refractory. Refractory are materials that can withstand very high temperature. What I am showing here is a muffle furnace which is lined by means of alumina refractory. The materials that are taken in the furnaces should not be heated directly by the heating element. Okay, the heat must be transferred from the heating element to the material through the refractory materials. So such a materials which can withstand very high temperature can be used as a lining in the furnaces. This experiment is about the determination of porosity of a refractory. The normal brick that we use for the construction purpose is also a refractory. Okay, its main use in the laboratories or lining. It's a lining material for the furnaces. It is very important to determine the porosity of a refractory. So this is because the porosity is directly connected to certain characteristics such as thermal conductivity, stability, and then abrasion resistance. If the porosity is very high, the thermal conductivity will be low and the strength will be low and the abrasion resistance will also be low. So it is very important to know about the porosity. So what I am showing here is the blast furnace that is used for manufacturing the metal from their ores. Ores are the minerals from which metals can be extracted. What is shown at the top is a cup and cone arrangement through which the furnaces can be fed with raw materials such as ore, limestone and coke, etc. And what is shown at the bottom in the red color is the molten metal. So there will be a separate outlet for it to remove. Above that, what is shown in black color is the slag, which is the unwanted byproduct. It can also be removed by an outlet. But these slag may penetrate into the pores of the refractory if the porosity is very high. Slag penetration may result in thermal spalling of the refractory. Thermal spalling means it's a property by which the refractory may undergo breaking and cracking. Okay, so normally it is better for a refractory to have low porosity or to have a moderate porosity. As a first step in the determination of porosity of a refractory, the sample bricks are washed thoroughly to remove dust particles and then they are kept in hot air oven, whereby they are heated gradually from 35 degrees Celsius to around 100 degrees Celsius. During heating, unwanted volatile substances and moisture are removed from the sample bricks. To bring down to room temperature, the sample bricks are kept in desiccator. I have not showed the desiccator here. It is a glassy apparatus consisting of calcium chloride. This is done to prevent further adsorption of moisture from the atmosphere. After that, when it has reached the room temperature, it has to be weighed. Now this particular sample piece weighs around 49.1 gram. After knowing the weight of sample brick, it must be boiled in distilled water for at least 15 minutes. This is done to fill up all the pores present in the brick. First, distilled water is taken in 250 ml beaker and placed in a heating mantle. When the water starts to boil, that time the sample brick must be dropped into it carefully using tongs. Okay, and ensure that the brick is completely immersed in the water. Okay, and after being boiled for at least 15 minutes, it should be taken out carefully. Alright, using tongs it can be taken out carefully and placed on a tissue paper. Then it should be wiped using the tissue paper itself to remove the excess water. When the sample is no more hot, that is when it has reached the room temperature and excess water is removed using tissue paper, it must be weighed. It is obvious that now the weight will be more than the initial weight because the pores of the refractory is filled with the water. So the initial weight was around 49.1 gram, which is taken as W1. Now the sample, after being boiled for about 15 minutes in distilled water, now it weighs around 51.1 gram. That is taken as the W2. The difference is 2 grams. Okay, so W2 minus W1 divided by W1 into 100 gives you the percentage of porosity. So 2 divided by the initial weight 49.1 into 100 is equal to 4%. So 4% is the porosity of our sample. Hope you understood, guys. Meet you all in next video. Thank you.